Ladies and gentlemen, we're back. Another interview here brought to you by Smash Studios and Battle for the East 2019. We're here, EVO 2019, at Mandalay Bay Convention Center. It's Rod the Dutch, but the homie standing next to me, man. World's Best Gaming, Vicky Kitty, how you doing?
I'm doing great. I mean, EVO 2019 is absolutely humongous. 3,500 players, dude. Like, what? We have so much international talent out here. This is going to be such a big deal to work with. I mean, I'm so happy that I'm actually able to witness everything going on here. It's history.
Yes. Well, at this point in time, Vicky, in your commentary career, you basically become a mainstay. You got a lot of fans at home. You got a lot of supporters. So with this in mind, there's no doubt in my mind that I'm not going to see you on the mic. Like, you're just one of the best in the game for a reason. So let's talk about day number one. How did everything go for you? I know you guys had, like, round one pools. Did you guys see anything crazy for the most part?
I actually didn't see anything insane. I was looking for upsets for the most part for all that day one.
Okay.
Didn't really see anything until this day two, which we also have phase one pool streaming this day as well. There are so many people here that they had to split pools up for two different days. But here, I believe Poltergust actually lost 2-0 or something to somebody. There's a few upsets, actually. Tyroy lost as well. He's in loser's bracket as well, lost in his pool. So we have a few upsets here and there, but nothing too extreme that I've seen so far.
Okay.
That's actually what I'm looking forward to, and something that I'm pretty sure we're going to get a lot of once we start breaking it down to the top 64 part of the bracket at EVO.
That's right. Wow, spoken like a true top commentator yourself. So talk to me about day number two. Day number one was kind of day number one. We know what kind of comes to that. We super chill, but today's the money day. And then, of course, everybody wants to bring it home for Sunday. So what are your thoughts on Saturday so far?
So far, I feel like today is going to be the big deal. I mean, we're going through the entire bracket until top eight.
That's right.
So at the end of the day, we are going to know who our top eight players are that are going to be playing tomorrow on the big stage at EVO. I think today is going to be honestly really busy for a lot of the players that have to go through their wave one pools as well. You got players like MVD out there, Tweak, that have to go through everything today, literally from waves one pools, phase two, top 64, you know, top 32, all the way down to finishing top 16. It's going to be a long day for everybody, but this is going to be the day that we're going to have the most upsets.
That's right. This is the day that history is made for everybody. If you guys don't know anything about EVO, be sure to follow EVO on Twitter at EVO. Somehow they ended up actually getting that username. I think it was EVO2K before, but of course, you know, EVO got the big bucks. So, Vicky, what's next on your agenda? Here we are at EVO. We were just a CEO together. What's the next tournament on your resume? Because I know you're never stopping.
It's so hard too, because being like a full-time student, I'm preparing myself for when fall term kicks up again. So it's going to be a little tough to juggle everything at the same time. But the next tournament on my list right now is actually next weekend for Super Smash Con 2019. So my eyes are set on that. I'm looking at Shine as well. So there's a lot of events coming up that I could work with and kind of take advantage of the time that I have left before school kicks up again for me. But, you know, until then, I'm going to be grinding it all the way through.
That's right. Now, Vicky, real quick, man, and I don't want to toot your own horn for you, but, you know, since your time in commentary, you've kind of opened up the door for a lot of other, not just female casters in Smash, but other fighting games as well, too. Do you have any words of advice for any up-and-coming commentators who are looking to really get their feet wet like you did?
Well, first of all, I just want to say I'm so, so happy that so many other girls are coming up on the mic, having that confidence to deliver and not second-guess themselves, because that's honestly, since you've known me, I've always said, you know, I want to create a wave where now more girls are coming up on the mic and feeling confident enough to say their story. You got Senpai out here making moves, commentating EVO 2019 too. We have Lyric out there at Tri-State working hard as well. And even for players of all ages, of all sex, that are trying to get into commentary, you have to start the same way as everybody else does, and that is to start at your locals. You gotta attend your locals. You gotta work hard, man. Let your TO recognize you. If you need advice, go to your TO. He's the only other guy who cares as much about commentary than you. I can assure you, it's really difficult to find people to give you constructive criticism if they aren't from the same background of commentary themselves. A lot of people are like, oh, you just go out there and you just talk, you know, that's so easy, but
yeah.
You have to think about your audience, you have to think about your delivery. You know, you're in round one pools, what kind of audience are you going to try to cater towards? And that's actually something that I'm studying in school right now, is figuring out your audience. You know, a lot of times people are like, Vicky's, you know, so basic with her information, but you know what, Smash Ultimate is so big that during wave one pools, people at home, like your grandmother, your mom, your brother, your sister,
right,
don't play the game competitively, need to understand what's going on in the game,
right,
to attract more spectators,
right,
to get people interested in coming out to tournaments.
That's
and of
right.
course, as we go through bracket, you have the top players doing a lot of crazy, intricate shenanigans that you could break that situation down with.
That's right.
And that's when you go down to the nitty-gritty. So, of course, start with your locals. Go to your regionals. Figure out who your players are, the top-level players that you have to deal with. And from there, you got a resume built up for you, you apply at a national, and from there you don't give up, because even if you get rejected once, you have so many other opportunities for you. There's an ultimate tournament happening every weekend. Get your resume built up and then apply.
That's right.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it first right there, man. From over all glaring analysis to in-depth match analysis to play-by-play to everything in between, Vicky Kitty has you covered. So real quick before we get out of here, man, where can all these wonderful people that are going to watch this interview find you on social media? Because they got to find you.
Hell yeah, man. I mean, you guys can find me at twitch.tv/VickyKitty. You got twitter.com/VickyKitty as well. Should be the first at that shows up there, because I actually managed to cop the @VickyKitty with no underscore. So we take those.
Yeah, you take those.
Hell yeah, guys. Thank you so much for watching.
That's right.
With this in mind, this concludes another interview here at the EVO Mandalay Bay Convention Center Smash Studios, brought to you by Battle for East 2019. Keep it locked right here. We'll be right back with more action right after this.